Hello, and welcome back to Music Movies. You know, it's amazing what some people will turn into a musical. I've already covered subjects like Reefer Madness that would make you think they'd suck, but actually turned out to be amazing when adapted into musical form. And sometimes all you really need is rhyming prose to adapt a series of books into a full-fledged musical, as Really Rosie demonstrated. But sometimes you don't even need that. In fact, the subject of today's musical also comes from the children's section at your local library. Mike Mulligan and His Steam Shovel by Virginia Lee Burton has been a staple of children's books for years. Despite being published in 1939 in the midst of the Great Depression, it was well known enough to be adapted into a short film in 1990, and according to a 2007 poll, the National Education Association ranked it as one of its teachers' top 100 books for children. Which is rather impressive when you consider that even in 1990, it's a pretty safe bet that most kids didn't know what a steam shovel was. I sure as hell didn't, and I was a kid when I read the book during the 90s. Getting back to that short film, though, the 1990 adaptation, directed by Michael Sporn and written and narrated by Robert Klein, was first commissioned for a little-known network called HBO. You've probably never heard of them. If that sounds crazy to you, remember that in 1996, HBO spun off into HBO Family for a place to put its more family-friendly programming. So the network that gave us Game of Thrones was also responsible for giving us a lot of decidedly more kid-friendly content, at least at the time. The short has since been released on DVD, and even though it's only 25 minutes long, it's stuck with me ever since I saw it as a kid. So, come with me as we revisit another piece of my childhood. So we open on a beautiful logo rise as we're introduced to Mike Mulligan and his steam shovel, Marianne, named after the Marion Steam Shovel Company. The narration informs us that Mike and Marianne are rather successful digging any hole the people need him to.
He always said that she could dig as much in a day as 100 men could dig in a week. But he had never been quite sure that this was true. When people used to stop and watch them, Mike Mulligan and Marianne used to dig a little faster and a little better.
This leads us to our first song of the movie.
Working together, we'll be friends forever. What we've got is nothing new. We're two old partners, tried and true. So wherever there is work to do, things will work out fine. For me and you.
The song is bright and cheerful, but Mike Mulligan's singing voice here reminds me of a coffee commercial jingle. Which isn't necessarily bad, it's also very soothing and relaxing. The music for this movie was composed by Bob Stein, who was also known for the soundtrack to Son of the Mask? So, the same guy who gave us this.
Good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you. I love you, baby. You feel like having a touch.
Gave us the music for Mike Mulligan and his steam shovel. Personally, though, I'd be more interested in the fact that Marianne, along with every shovel we'll see in this movie, seems to be sentient. But people treat this like it's no big thing. Have these fools learned nothing from the rampage of Killdozer?
It was Mike Mulligan and Marianne, and some others, who dug the great canals for the big boats to sail through.
I like that. Mike Mulligan and Marianne did all this. Oh, and some other people helped too. They don't really matter. But it's only a matter of time before obsolescence marches on and Mike Mulligan's jobs start getting taken by other more powerful shovels that don't run on coal. And all the other steam shovels are getting scrapped, which is really gruesome if you remember that they're sentient like the other shovels in this movie. Oh, and speaking of other shovels... I cannot fathom the mind of the person who read Mike Mulligan and his steam shovel and said, you know what this needs? A gospel-inspired villain song. But that person is a mad genius because this song is unbelievably catchy. But in the face of this villain song, our heroes are forced to acknowledge that no one really wants their work anymore.
What are we gonna do? one seems to want us anymore.
With one of the saddest songs I think I'll ever hear. Seriously, you could extrapolate a lot from this song. Depression, loss, and being left behind by things that seem like a natural process to everyone else. Obsolescence is sadly a fact of life, but we often forget just how many people lose their place because of it. Jeez, maybe my Mulligan is more universal than I thought. However, our heroes finally catch a break when they learn that the town of Popperville is going to build a new town hall, and they need someone to dig the cellar for it. And Mike, to prove that he and Marianne have still got it, bet that they can dig it in one day. The guy they tell this to, Henry B. Swap, one of the people in charge of the project, is kind of presented as a villain, but I don't really know why. They give a lot of focus to how mean he smiles, and he's confident that Mike can't do the project in one day as he says he can.
But really, would you be? Honestly, with how slow construction runs on highways these days, I'd give him a month at the least.
Mike even bets Henry that if he can't dig the cellar in one day, he won't have to pay him. Now this is going overboard, Mike. I know you believe in how powerful your shovel is, but you don't even know if she's capable of this. But either way, the bet is made and the two start digging. A little boy comes to watch him, and as we've established, Mike and Marianne can dig faster when people watch them dig. So the little boy starts telling more and more people about the cellar, and because people really had nothing better to do back then, more people start coming to watch.
Oh man, here comes the nostalgia bomb.
If they say it's impossible, tell them it just takes longer. Cause no one but you knows what you can do, and believing it makes you stronger. A cellar in a day, a cellar in a day. Even if it can't be done, do it anyway.
This song is, no exaggeration, the reason I remembered this movie as a kid. It was used in a promo for being aired on HBO, and after hearing it, I was hooked. I had to stay and watch it. And honestly, it's not hard to see why. The song is so upbeat and catchy, and just listen to that sax and guitar. It really does make you feel like you can accomplish the impossible, especially if you're a kid. And hey, it was nicer than to bring in Mr. Ed for a cameo.
It always helps when there's someone else standing there beside you.
If you forget your way, it'll be okay.
Cause you got a friend to remind you.
Anyway, more and more people, even from neighboring towns, start coming in to watch Mike and Marianne dig.
Including the fire department. Boy, it sure is a good thing there weren't any fires that day.
And man, I'm not the only one who loves this song, because they let it go on for a while. But when it's over, Mike and Marianne have dug the cellar just in time. But uh-oh, it looks like they forgot one thing, a way out. So according to Henry B. Swap, they haven't dug the full cellar. Come on, man, at this point just give it to them. They saved you a ton of money. However, again, it's the little boy who comes up with a great idea. I think.
Why couldn't we leave Marianne in the cellar and build a new town hall above her? Let her be the furnace for the new town hall and let Mike Mulligan be the janitor. Then you wouldn't have to buy a new furnace, and we could pay Mike Mulligan for digging the cellar in just one day.
I don't know. I mean, I guess having a steady job is better than having no work at all, but would you really want to be a janitor for the rest of your life?
And how does Marianne feel about this? She's going to be stuck in one place for the rest of her life, however long that is, and what happens when Mike dies? Well, whatever. Happy ending. Question mark.
Mike Mulligan and his steam shovel, much like the book, has stood the test of time surprisingly well.
If the movie has one weakness, it's the sketchy and somewhat dated crayon and colored pencil look of the animation, but even that has its charm. It follows the original story quite well, which is already pretty timeless even if a lot of the machines featured in it are no longer used. It deals with universal themes like the fear of being left behind, being made obsolete, as well as learning to deal with a situation even in the face of adversity. And the songs, instead of taking away from the story, only add spice to an already solid meal. They're all quite well written and catchy, and whether you're a kid or a kid at heart, I still think you'll find them enjoyable.
But now it's time to decide which is the most enjoyable. It's time for Best and Worst. Which of these songs rises triumphantly like a puff of smoke, and which needs to be buried under Town Hall? For best, if you had asked me when I was a kid, I definitely would have said Do It Anyway. And it's still up there, I could gush about this song all day. But as I've grown older, I've gotten more of an appreciation for No Steam Shovels Wanted. Like I said, you kind of have to appreciate the mad genius of throwing in this strange gospel choir villain song in the middle of this particular story. And it's so different than the other songs, which I suppose is because Mike Mulligan sings on every song except this one. Plus, like I said, every song in this movie is catchy, and this is no exception. For worst, it's honestly a tough call because all four of these songs are good. But if I had to pick, I'm going with the first one, Working Together. Out of all of these songs, I'd have to say it's the most generic. It's still well sung, but like I said, it kind of reminds me of a commercial jingle, and that's not a good thing. The other songs are much more situational and memorable. The short is available on DVD, and I highly recommend that you check it out, or even show it to your kids. Supposedly, it's sometimes still aired as an HBO storybook classic, but since I don't have HBO anymore, I can't watch it. But remember, sometimes, no matter how bad things get, and you think you can't do anything, do it anyway. You've got nothing to lose by trying.
If they say it's impossible, tell them it just takes longer. 'Cause no one but you knows what you can do, and believing it makes you stronger. A seller in a day. A seller in a day. Even if it can't be done, do it anyway.
It always helps when there's someone else standing there beside you.
If you forget your way, it'll be okay.
'Cause you got a friend to remind you.